Great. So finally we are here, and this is my second attempt at this webinar on this new application. And yes, what I'm going to share with you today is an amazing topic. And to start with, I would like to welcome all of you who have logged in right now on this webinar, special webinar. And the topic for today is, of course, Ganoderma lucidum. I'll share some things that I've learned over the last 5 years. For the people who are new, I would like to introduce myself. I'm Dr. Rajesh Savera, an Ayurveda physician, a psychotherapist and a counselor. And now I term myself as a healer, because I basically believe that with herbs, food and nutrition, you set up a healing system within your body. Now, what I am going to do now is going to turn off the webcam. We will take the question and answers later. But for now, I'm going to turn off the webcam and I'm going to go on my presentation. And let's try to cover up the topic in the next 30 to 45 minutes so that I could share whatever I can in the best possible way in the shortest time. So while I turn off the webcam, I go back on my slides here. Now, what you see on screen is a roadmap, or probably the boards or the maps that say what kind of diseases people are suffering from. And this is all those diseases that people live with, like osteoporosis, heart disease, rheumatism, arthritis, heartburn, diabetes, cancer, obesity, IBS, that's irritable bowel syndrome, and gout, and many more, actually. And these are all called in single term as chronic diseases. Now, chronic diseases are globally present, and I think so majority of the population suffers from it. There's no direct answer for these diseases. You have to live with them, either by popping a pill every day, which a doctor gives you through a course, and yet there is never an end. I haven't seen any diabetes person who would say that, yes, after taking a short course of 3 months or 6 months and he was off the pills. No, I haven't seen one with an arthritis who said with painkillers, he's off the painkillers. So the fact is that more than 50% of the world's population lives with chronic diseases. And that is really alarming, that the huge number, 50%. And is there a way out? Of course, it's not going to help us only by popping pills. We'll have to find a way out, and that is through food and nutrition. And that's where I want to introduce you to this amazing mushroom known as Ganoderma. Now, this is a medicinal mushroom, and I believe it's got those ingredients in it that can heal you. Now, healing is an automated process within the body. You provide it with enough nutrients, body has its own mechanism to heal itself. Like if you say a cut and an injury or wound on your skin, the body sets up a clot mechanism through which your bleeding stops. And this process of healing is happening every now and then. That's where when we sleep, our body goes into the repair mode and repairs us so that we are fit and fine again every day, next day morning. So what is this medicinal mushroom? And how is it going to help me? That's going to be my topic. And in the webinars to follow, I would try my best to share one amazing herb or supplement that we can add into our lives that can really help us trigger the healing system within. Now, Ganoderma, the name is derived from the Greek word ganos. That means the brightness or sheen. Derma is the skin. This mushroom has a shiny skin, and that is why it is called as Ganoderma with a Greek origin. But when you look at Ganoderma, it belongs to the Basidiospores family. And here Ganoderma genus is a polypore mushroom, and it usually grows on woods, trees, either living trees or dead trees or logs. And it includes almost 80 species. 80 different species that have been found out right now, and these are found everywhere around the world, and especially in the tropical regions. Now, polypores are a group of fungi that form the fruiting bodies with pores or tubes on the inside or the underside of the mushroom. So the top part would be like a woody structure, and below that would be these porous tubes through which, you know, later on the mushroom basically releases the spores. And the amazing thing about this whole phenomena is the mushroom is basically just the reproductive part of the species called fungi. And so when it knows that the food and nutrition is taken enough and it wants to spread its species across, it actually passes on the whole spores. And the amazing thing about Ganoderma lucidum that I'm going to talk to about the species out of the 80 is the one which has a double coated spore. So it's very difficult to germinate, and that is why it is one of the rare mushrooms. And as you go into my webinar, you know, we will realize how important it was. Now, there are two out of the 80. I want to bring to you a few species that you can find around. The one that you see right now is not the shiny skin. This is like more like the woody, rough thing. It is called as Ganoderma aplatinatum. And this species is basically found across woods, and it has got certain medicinal values, but it's not much talked about. The second variety that you see here is more like multipetals, and that is why it is called as Ganoderma multipetalum. Now here, when I say this particular species, you will see the more decorative kind. Again, the debate still continues whether this is that immortal herb that actually has helped people to heal themselves. But again, this is not the species that we are going to talk about today. This is Ganoderma sugae. Now here, this is very similar to Ganoderma lucidum. It's got a shiny skin, it grows on trees, but it's a little different in terms of its functionality. Now this is very important. When you look at mushrooms, they all look similar, or they are very they look alike, but functionally every species, and within its species every type, has a very specific function. And this one that I'm showing you right now on screen is Ganoderma lucidum. This is also known as Rishi or Lingzi. It is a very valuable medicine in Asian herbal medicine, especially in the traditional Chinese medicine, and where it is termed as the king of herbs. Even the the first, you can say, the father of traditional Chinese medicine, Wu Shennong, he actually promotes and has said about Rishi a lot. So here, when you look at what Lingzi or Rishi means, is Lingzi in Chinese means the mushroom of immortality. Now, immortality is what was a quest always. Humans always searched out for some elixir or herb, food, metal, something that when taken can take care of illness and death. And that's where when Lingzi, when it's being termed as mushroom of immortality, has some significance in the healing system. Similarly, in Japanese tradition, this mushroom is known as Rishi. That means 10,000 year mushroom. That when you consume it, you actually live like that. And this again, if you see, people have actually influenced another people. Civilization have influenced another civilization. It's said that the whole concepts of immortality began somewhere in the Greek or the Indian subcontinent, where it then started to spread across. And the elixir of life that people were talking about, that's where triggered other civilizations to find out. And that's how it went from India to China, from China to Japan and other countries in Southeast Asia. Now here I'm showing you a picture of the god of longevity, that's Shaoxia, is a Chinese god. And out of the three gods, the one that grants you immortality or actually works at the span of your life is this Shaustar god. And if you look at him, he's holding in one hand the peach of immortality. It again is another fruit that people talk about. And for me, I believe it is, when you say a peach, peach signifies the fruit of a tree. That means vegetation. When you eat good food, that is your source of immortality. But along with that, on the stick, you see, he is tied up a mushroom. That's the Ganoderma lucidum, Lingzi. And that again shows that not only food, but you need some supplements along with it for you to achieve that longevity. And that's where I believe the traditional Chinese medicine incorporated this concept of adding, along with certain medicines, certain herbs that could increase the potency of that herb. This concept also goes back in India. When, like, I'm an Ayurveda physician and we have studied herbs. The concept about adding something called as rasayana, it's like a catalyst that actually improves the herb function, or even not only a herb function, also the foods that you eat. It improves their absorption, their elimination. And such rasayanas or catalysts, they actually help in detoxifying and also nourishing the system and enhancing the food and the medicines that you take. And that's probably how Rishi got its position as the elixir mushroom of immortality, because it was being used quite often. When you talk about this mushroom, we cannot forget the first emperor of China, that's who belonged to the Qin dynasty. His name was Qin Shi Huang. And he basically, if you look at the picture I've shown you, this was one of those terracotta findings of the soldiers from his tomb, you know, a huge tomb. You can Google around it, you know, the terracotta army of Qin Shi Huang. And you'll find that he was very powerful. He was the first person who united China under his rule. But he feared one thing, and it is said that he feared death, and he wanted to conquer even death. And that is why he was in search of those immortal herbs. And that's when he sent his magicians to different places across the globe to find out where is that immortal herb that when consumed, one can live forever. And the story goes on that that's where some of the people travel across the Indian subcontinent, and they get to know about some magical food or mushroom or herb known as Soma, and they were interested in it, and that's how it goes to him. But not during his reign that Lingzi got its popularity, but during the next generation of kings, especially in the Han dynasty, that Lingzi got its value, and then it started being used in art form and everything. In the last few years, especially in the last 5 to 10 years, the world has now gone back to understanding that food supplements, nutrition is going to play a vital role in healing of chronic diseases. And a lot of research has been done on Rishi, this Ganoderma. And it has attracted a lot of scientific and medical community who have found through clinical studies, almost 2,000 peer-reviewed studies are available on the internet, abstracts and all those things, especially on PubMed. If you go to the PubMed.com, you can probably have more information on the research that has been done. What they found is that compounds within the mushroom fruit body, especially the spores, have shown remarkable pharmacological and therapeutic activity. Now, hello, good morning. Okay, here. So, news is now covering up how this mushroom can be the shield for protecting you from cancer. And many more information now, people are becoming more aware of this because of the means of education that people share. But here and on this webinar, I would like to share 6 benefits of Rishi mushroom. The first one in my previous webinar, we saw that how Reishi was one of the most potent detoxifiers that helps you eliminate the toxins, the natural as well as the chemical toxins that come into our system because of which we fall ill. So it is basically a detoxifier, but here it also defends against tumor growth and cancer. And this it does because of its ability to find out those cells whose, you know, what happens in cancer is the dead cell death ratio goes down and the cells don't die. So there is a lifespan for everything. So this mushroom has the ability to trigger out those cells and see that they achieve their mortalities and so on, give a chance for the new cells to grow. That's what this mushroom can do. Second, it improves liver function and detoxification. And that's the most important thing, because liver is a very important organ in terms of not only purification of blood, but also detoxifying it. And Ganoderma really helps the liver. Liver, if you all know, is one of the only organs that has the ability to regenerate itself. Ganoderma acting out there helps the regeneration of the liver cells and helps the liver to live longer and do its function much better for a longer period of time. The third one is it promotes heart health and balances the blood pressure. This is very significant. Now here, if I have to explain this, how it does is because Lingzhi is a diuretic. Now heart, while it pumps the blood, it depends also on the excretion. So when the urine, because the kidneys and the heart are very closely related functionally, when the kidneys are able to reduce the load through urination, the heart actually relaxes. So the key is to get the extra fluid load, the cleansing done better through herbs which are diuretic, and they can actually help the cardiac functioning. So it definitely helps cardiac health and balancing the blood pressure, which definitely gets reduced with you taking Lingzhi. It also helps in balancing the hormones and can fight diabetes, again another hormonal disease. Now hormones are secretions of the cells from particular endocrine organs. Now these have special functions. Each hormone has a specific function, but at the end these hormones are secreted by the cells themselves. So if you can maintain healthy cells, the secretions of these cells definitely is maintained. And so for any condition where there is a hormonal imbalance, could be hypothyroidism, hyperthyroidism, obesity, it could be diabetes, anything, adding Reishi into your supplement range will definitely help you balance those hormones. The fifth one is it fights allergies and asthma, which is again an allergic condition. Now allergies are basically body's response, kind of an inflammatory response to antigens which the body has to prepare antibodies for and try to attack them. When you reduce the acidic environment within your body actually becomes free of allergies, because the rate with which your body tends to fight these allergens reduces drastically. So very good positive effect on people with asthma, skin allergies. And the sixth, it reduces the risk of infections and viruses, which is now the key. With a lot of conditions like dengue and other viral diseases that are spreading across the globe, we need our immune system to become really, really strong enough and to fight or create antibodies within ourselves and protect us from the various infections that we might be affected with, so especially viral conditions. And here again, Reishi has really proved to be the first choice as a supplement that helps in all these things. Now, compounds like called triterpenes that are found have been shown to detect and reduce the programmed cell death in wrongly proliferated cells without harming healthy cells. Now here, I want to bring your notice to triterpenes. These are very important. And the ones that you find in Ganoderma actually help in cancer because of this particular action, where it can detect and reduce these programmed cell death in wrongly programmed cells, you know, they do through the inducing them and killing them. And the second is it is rich in antioxidants. Now, these are compounds, you know, which have the scavenging free radical ability, and they protect the mitochondrial DNA. Now, damage to the mitochondrial DNA by free radical is believed to be the major cause factor for aging and disease. But when you take Ganoderma, you're actually protecting your mitochondrial DNA, and they are the energy stores of your cells. And once you protect your energy stores, you actually can live longer. That's the key. The third one is it is rich in polysaccharides. Now, this helps us because it enhances our immune system. It stimulates immune cells, especially macrophages and natural killer cells, and thus helps us to fight various diseases in future. Any kind of infections and all those things, our immunity builds up. Now, here there's a comparative study shown of different types of mushrooms. And if you look at it, when you see Ganoderma lucidum, you see it has scored in almost all the categories that mushrooms were studied as an antibacterial, anti-candida, anti-inflammatory, antioxidant, anti-tumor, antiviral, for maintaining blood pressure, blood sugar levels, then for cardiovascular system. All of these, if you look at it, it really helps the immune system, the kidney tonic, liver tonic, so nerve tonic. I believe this becomes your first choice, and probably that is why the ancient people called it the king of herbs, because of its amazing healing ability. Now, the next question definitely pops up in the mind is, what is DXN, and why DXN Ganoderma is one of the best, and why should I recommend that? DXN basically is one of these companies that I claim to be the world's largest producers, manufacturers, and suppliers of Ganoderma to the world. And that's an organic Ganoderma, and they have been doing that for a long time. Now, why you need to take that? I hear somebody saying you can't hear you from Turkey. Can the others hear me? Erin from Turkey says she can't hear me. What, can others hear me? Can somebody just... Okay, I get a confirmation. Everything fine? Okay, good. Thanks, Bobin, for confirming. Erin, you can check your audio system. We can continue with our webinar. Now here, when you look at the wild variety of Ganoderma, I would never suggest to take any mushroom if you don't know where it comes from, because the ones today, even the wild ones, could be very, very toxic because we don't know what they are feeding on. And mushrooms have the ability to feed on anything. They are saprophytes, so they would feed on a dead snake or a poisonous scorpion. And those toxins, the alkaloids, the poisonous alkaloids, could become a part of the mushroom body itself. And when taken, can really cause a lot of damage to you. It could damage your kidneys, because that's where it first primarily acts. It could damage your liver, because that's another action it has on. And it could really affect your cardiac functions, because again, these are the primary vital organs that Ganoderma works on. And if taken not of a good quality, these are the same organs that can be affected. Now, I definitely don't suggest anyone to take Ganoderma if you don't know the origin of. What's so special about DXN is all because of this man that you see on screen wearing the cap of DXN. That is Dr. Lim Seo Jin. He's the CEO and founder, a great scientist, researcher, and his interest on this medicinal mushroom has paved way for these millions of people that have healed because of him. He managed to come up with an amazing way of producing and growing these mushrooms. And DXN is a Malaysian-based company, and we have a farm, the world's largest Ganoderma farm in Kedah, Malaysia. It's a completely organic farm. Everything is taken care of, and Dr. Lim came up with this amazing research-based techniques with tissue culture technology he added, and he saw and he managed to get these mushrooms to grow in a natural environment, maintaining its same qualities and getting the best premium quality every time, every batch, produce the better variety. And in the last 25 years or so, DXN has been managed to give the world the best variety of Ganoderma. And that's where I would say that if you want to buy from a company that actually knows where the source is, and then that's the best thing to buy. What and how do I know that Ganoderma is working for me? The best thing is to know that Ganoderma is a diuretic, a natural diuretic. And if you look at it, the best thing to know that the Ganoderma has started to work for me, you can start with a little small, around a gram of Ganoderma powder. And you will see that if you have a good flushing, if your kidneys have started to flush, that means your Ganoderma is working for you. And I know for sure, if your kidneys keep on flushing the urine out, that's where you'll keep on living happily, because that's where the key of health is. Getting your urination, your kidneys to function optimally for the rest of your life. If you can manage to do that, you will be able to live the maximum. So that's the key, and that's where Ganoderma really is one of your first choice. Now, kidneys are the organs that keep on filtering every now and then, and through microfiltration, through the glomerular filtri. And we have to actually give something that actually can push while the kidneys and everything pump together, while the heart pumps hard, so that the fluid, the blood can rush through these small arterioles in the nephrons, so that the purification happens. I believe when we add something like Rishi, you're stimulating a better cleansing system, and the kidneys, they can actually be flushed out themselves. Now, suddenly urine that was more acidic, which usually, of course, but when you add Ganoderma, it becomes more less acidic, and that's a really good advantage, because suddenly my kidneys can now be living longer. Today kidney failure is a common problem, because the kind of acidic urine that we have been creating within ourselves with the kind of foods that we have been eating has actually damaged the whole, the structure, the architecture of the kidneys at the micro level. And dialysis cannot be the answer. One simple thing to prevent the future dialysis, one has to understand that I need to see that I urinate well, and that also through a system which is more, my urine is more alkaline, not acidic. So here is one chance with Ganoderma, you can actually do that. DXN offers two variants in its Ganoderma. One is the fruit body, the one that I show you, the shiny skinned fruit. That is, in DXN we call it Rishi Gano, RG. I always suggest to start with, you can always start with, for a normal adult male, 4 capsules 3 times a day is good enough. That's around 1 gram. And that's good enough to trigger a nice diuresis and a good healing system within you if you're not suffering from any condition. This is good for prevention. Same, if you look down, we have another variant. It's called GL, Ganocelium. The one on the top is Rishi Gano, RG. The down is Ganocelium, GL. Now, this is the mycelium, the root of the mushroom. Now, the root of the mushroom is like, if I hold a cotton in my hand, and it's exactly like that. Very thin fibers, network of fibers spreading across its host and feeding on it, supplying all the nutrients to form the reproductive body called the fruit body. But this is really rich in nutrients, rich in polysaccharides, triterpenes. And I believe this can be one of your alkaline food to supplement yourself with enough nutrients, and that can trigger healing too. So we always say, yin and yang, we take it together. And for yin and yang to take together, we have to understand that in RG and GL, you're taking the fruit and the root together. This is really amazing. When you take this together, it really helps up the healing system. Things you need to watch for when you take Rishi Gano, RG and GL is drink a lot of water. because that's what it does. It cleans up the system. It acts as diuretic. It actually cleans up the system. So make sure that you're drinking enough water. Don't feel dehydrated. Watch for your skin. Your skin should not be dry, because skin is an indication. If your skin is getting dry, then you know for sure that your mucosa inside your intestines and everywhere also would be getting dry. So definitely drink a lot of water. Make sure you add some food oil, especially I recommend two types of oil. Virgin coconut oil, that helps in lubrication. This is an added advantage, because when you take Ganoderma and you have these diuresis, your body is left with, you know, there could be a chance that you could show up some symptoms called as reflections, wherein the organ that is most weakest or affected can actually show up symptoms again more. You know, I've seen people with diabetes, you know, when they take Ganoderma and they have their blood sugars around 150, 160. And when they start Ganoderma, suddenly they come to me and they say, hey, doctor, I took this and within 1 week, my blood sugar jumped up from 150 to 200. And I always tell them that's because you have lost fluid and your same sugar level has now showing up more on the labs. So I always suggest them to support yourself with enough oil so that you don't show up these symptoms that come along with the use of Ganoderma. So virgin coconut oil, a tablespoon or two to three times a day will really help to reduce that. Second, if you cannot get virgin coconut oil, the second best oil I would suggest, especially in the European region, is virgin olive oil. That again is amazing combo along with Ganoderma. You can add that also one or two spoonful, two, three times a day. And you can have it directly or with food. It's your choice. But you need to make sure that you have. And pop in a lot of oil containing nuts, you know, fruits. So that you basically now, like, you can take a lot of cashews, you can take almonds and all those things along when you're doing your detoxification or healing with Ganoderma. While you're doing that internally with the oil, make sure that you apply oil to your skin too, because that's another entry for the oil. And it also prevents the water loss that happens through transpiration. You know, one, we sweat, and the other thing is we lose a lot of water because of the environment being hot outside. Our skin loses water. But when you apply oil, you're putting a coat so that you don't lose your moisture from inside out to the conditions that are prevalent outside. So this is another advantage I would suggest if you want to not see any symptoms like this skin rashes or dryness of the skin. When you start taking Ganoderma, we have an amazing palm oil with Ganoderma, which is really effective. The amazing thing of adding Ganoderma to oils and other food products and supplements and daily care products is because Ganoderma has a specific action against other fungi too. Let's say, for example, Candida. Ganoderma has a very good effects against Candida. And again, when you use Ganoderma based oil for your application, could be your joint pain or could be overall skin massage, it really helps. Then I suggest you add a lot of antioxidants, because Ganoderma is an antioxidant, but along with that, you need to take a lot of beverages. Beverages have really helped people to heal themselves. They take care of your hunger cravings, they manage your hormonal levels and all those things. Taking coffee. Now, the coffee is amazing. Coffee has its own medicinal value. But added with Ganoderma, it really helps. So, one is while you drink a lot of water, but water cannot only suffice the fluid needs when you need. Make sure that you drink quite often coffees with Ganoderma. Again, in my last 5 years of travel across the globe, I have seen one thing, that even those people who have just taken the Ganoderma coffee of DXN have said that they have felt amazing. And the reason being very simple, what seems magic for them is science for me, because coffee itself in its bitter form is a diuretic. Add it with Ganoderma, it's an amazing cleanser. And that's where they feel only by detoxification cleansing the benefits of healing. Same is with tea, and especially in countries like Turkey and everywhere, you already have tea. But if you cut off the sugar from that tea and add Ganoderma to it, it will be amazing. You can have it like you can brew your own tea or coffee and open a capsule of RG or GL and you can have it like that. Or you can take directly off a tea that is offered by DXN because it's already contained Ganoderma in it. And this tea itself can become a healing beverage. Now, I live in Pune in India, and we travel across my city and neighboring villages and cities. And I talk about tea. We are trying to change the way we drink tea. And in the last 1 year, we have got so many testimonials of people feeling healed from various conditions. And I, for them, again, it's magic that how can the same tea that caused me problem and the right way of taking it has become one of the means of healing me. So people have lost weight. People have cured their blood pressures, their diabetes, you know, had a lot of skin allergies, all that only because of tea and coffee. And that's amazing. Now, I want to add here something that we need to consider is DXN is probably one of those only companies that I know from many other. But what I know is that manufactures a toothpaste made out of Ganoderma. This can be a real boon for dentists who are still trying to tackle conditions of oral health care, the preventive aspect. Now, one who uses Ganoderma toothpaste, you know, the Ganoderma-based toothpaste, will see a drastic change in the oral mucosa. Suddenly, I'm not talking about the teeth. I'm talking about the whole oral mucosa. Your gums get stronger. Now, if your gums are strong, they can hold on to your teeth. Then your tongue, the mucosa is maintained well. So that again helps in your digestion, your food, your salivation, everything. Then it has got good antifungal and antibacterial properties, the Ganoderma itself. So there was a research done. You can Google around Ganoderma toothpaste and you'll find the research done saying that how effective this toothpaste was against Candida albicans. And now this is really good because a lot of immunocompromised people today are having these oral thrush, the white fungus going on their tongue. And only by application of this toothpaste, it has really helped. And because it acts as an antifungal, people still use it in different ways. You know, we like to use one product in many ways. Though it's a toothpaste, I've heard people using it for skin conditions, burns and everything, only because it contains all the safe elements from food gel to Ganoderma. And that's an amazing thing to have, you know. I personally have been using and my family have been using it for a long time now. And we are a complete fan of Ganoderma toothpaste. And now comes the soap. The reason I'm sharing this is again because skin is where your dead cells are shed off. And dead cells are where fungus and bacteria thrive. You need something that can actually heal your clean up your skin and also take care of those bacteria and fungi. And here you have Ganoderma-based soap with, you know, palm oil in it. So it definitely acts like a cream-based soap, doesn't dry up your skin. And again, it's one of the most amazing soaps that a lot of beauticians like Roshanara Ahmed and other people talk about. And I've seen the benefits of it again on various skin conditions. Things you need to follow when you're with on Ganoderma or when you're a part of DXN, a company that believes in healing your chronic diseases through a lifestyle change, I believe you need to cut down or stop that white sugar. It's one of the most acidic foods that we have been consuming and making our body acidic. It takes away the whole essence of living. You know, it's like the only thing that can really help us is to get away from this. We are addicts of this sugar and we have to now work towards de-addiction. And that's where DXN can be your first step. Second, red meat is okay, but not good enough when you're going through a cleanse. Once you have a body that's good enough, you're strong, you're healthy, But in a state when you're diseased, taking red meat means adding the body, giving it more chance to go and digest that, where it loses its energy. I believe at that time you need to go on more vegetarian-based diet, not too much of protein, because proteins turn out to become more acidic. You can go on natural proteins which are not acidic, like spirulina, chlorella. But here I would suggest to cut down on meat. If you can set yourself free from gluten, probably 99% of the population is allergic to gluten, even without knowing that they are allergic. Conditions like simple acidity or constipation, skin conditions, irritability, pigmentation, they are all attributed to gluten allergy. And your gut is where it gets affected. Cause of many conditions like piles, fissures, irritable bowel syndrome. And when you're on Ganoderma, you don't want to use an allergen quite often. So I would definitely suggest to cut down on gluten also. Avoid as much chemicals you can that you put into your body, the deodorants and the sprays and aftershave lotions and all those chemicals as much as you can reduce. Don't pollute your system within. Watch on what you eat. Try to avoid junk food. Junk food in Ayurveda is described as any food that is cooked overnight. And so try to cook something fresh for yourself. And here I come to know, I got a question today from somebody who asked me, when you talk about DX and fermented coffee, you know, how beneficial is it? I said, it's very, very beneficial, because usually when you go to coffee, you know, even the fermented coffee, when you have that, you actually boil it up, and you then, in the process in boiling, you have to kill the bacteria and everything gets destroyed. But with DXN, you have ready to take, you know, sachets. It's so nice, you know. You just take a cup, you open, you have the coffee with all the beneficial bacteria like probiotics. You open it, you put a little hot water in it, that's it. And you're just sipping it. So you are getting the benefits of the coffee, like instant coffee. And that's amazing. And that's why I'm saying, you know, you need to watch on what you take as diet. Okay, try to reduce even your you can say dairy products, because again, a lot of them are allergic, because cows today are injected more with hormones to increase their productivity. And I would definitely suggest you to be taking that less in comparison to these green vegetables and fruits that you can. Try to find the organic ones, wash it up clean, take good fiber, because your gut, your intestine needs good fiber. Only then the peristalsis keeps on working. And that's where you try to add a lot of fiber in your diet. That's where this path that we don't want to go, taking any of these routes, we don't want to suffer from any of these conditions, you know. And that's where I think, if you want to set yourself free, you need to understand that we don't want to be among that 50% of the population that lives with chronic diseases. We can actually live without any disease. That's what we are meant to be. But it's our lifestyle and the food that we have been eating. That's the reason that we are suffering. And look at the statistics, and they are really alarming. They have just put down four, you know, diabetes, heart disease, cancer, stroke. But I say there are many more. And chronic diseases account for 3 out of 4 deaths. And that's not... This is what I say. Immortality is dying old, dying with old age, dying when your hair have fallen, your beard has become white, your skin has dried up completely. That is immortality. But dying young is called mortality. And out of 4 now, if you look at 3 people are dying early before actually going through the old age and suffering. And that's the journey. You know, I believe that with DXN, you will be taking your first step. I stand for DXN because it has been one of the companies that matched with my philosophy of healing and wellness. And my philosophy of healing and wellness comes from the 5,000-year-old philosophy of Ayurveda, which believes that everything in the world, if taken in the right manner, can actually become a healing thing. For more information, you all who are new here can log on to www.dxntu.com, get to know more about the company, and get to know the amazing products that we offer. I would be taking up many more webinars. Each termed at a particular mushroom or fruit or an algae or some supplements, some disease, so as to educate everyone that we can live without disease. That's my email address, drrajeshsavera@gmail.com. You are free to write to me anytime. I keep on answering at least around 15 to 20 mails every day from people across the globe. And you can definitely write to me with your personal queries also. I'm very happy to help you with anything that you want. So again, thank you very much for being there on this special webinar that I played today. And I hope I will see you all soon next week at 10 p.m. IST, Indian Standard Time. And we'll be very glad to have you all join me. Please try to spread the word and get more people to understand the benefits of Reishi, because Reishi is one of the amazing mushrooms that you can really help people. I am open for questions about the next 5 minutes before I log off, because we have finished almost 47 minutes. And that's a long time, 45 minutes. So if anybody questions, you can definitely type in and I will try to answer that. Okay. So no questions by now? Okay, fine. Seems there are no questions coming up. Again, thank you so much. The guys that wrote to me, hi Sanjay, hi Ravi, hi Ivan, hi Sonu, DXN from Sharjah, Gemma, hi Gemma, Martin, Siddharth and Suman. Thank you so much for joining and writing to me. See you again next week at 10 p.m. Every Saturday with the next webinar. And my next webinar is on coffee. Don't miss it. I have some amazing stuff to tell you all. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.